Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss one of the important topics for theoretical exams as well as for the competitive exam, that is Introduction to Lipoproteins. Learning objective for today's video are, first we will see definition of lipoproteins, second objective is structure of lipoproteins, then we will see composition and characteristic of lipoproteins, then we will see function of lipoproteins as well as lipoproteins along with the various multiple choice question asked from this particular topic. So first, definition of lipoproteins. Lipoproteins are the compound lipids which formed as a combination of lipids with proteins, and the protein part of lipoproteins are known as a apolipoproteins. These lipoproteins help in the transport of lipids in the plasma. Now we will see the structure of lipoproteins. As we all know that lipids are water insoluble compounds and they are not transported as such in the plasma. So the alternative arrangement is made in the form of lipoproteins. Lipoproteins are having the core of non-polar lipids which contains triacylglycerol and cholesterol ester. This core of non-polar lipid is surrounded by monolayer of amphipathic lipids which contains phospholipid as well as free cholesterol, and the outermost layer is of peripheral apoprotein. So this is the picture showing the structure of lipoprotein. Classification of lipoproteins. Lipoproteins are classified under five major categories based on the separation of ultracentrifugation. So the first class is chylomicrons. Second one is very low density lipoproteins. Third one is intermediate density lipoprotein. Fourth one is low density lipoprotein. And the fifth one is high density lipoprotein. Free fatty acids which are complex with albumin are not generally included in the classification of lipoproteins because they are very loosely bound. So this is the classification of lipoproteins based on their separation in the ultracentrifugation. This is the picture showing the separation of lipoproteins in the ultracentrifugation as well as in the electrophoresis. So based on the ultracentrifugation, the ascending order of density, first is chylomicron, which has least density, then there is a very low density lipoprotein, then intermediate density lipoprotein, then low density lipoprotein, and then high density lipoprotein, which has higher density. So this is the picture showing the separation of lipoproteins in the ultracentrifugation. And this is the picture showing the separation of lipoproteins in the electrophoresis. And the mobility of lipoproteins in the electrophoresis is based on the protein content. Higher the protein content, higher will be the mobility. Say for example, HDL has around 50% of protein, so it will have a higher mobility, while the chylomicron, which has the least protein content, so it will remain at the origin. So this is the picture showing the separation of lipoproteins in the electrophoresis from negative, that is cathode, to positive, that is anode. This is the picture showing the comparative size of lipoproteins. Chylomicron is big among all the lipoproteins and the HDL is small among all the lipoproteins. So this is the picture showing the comparison of size of lipoproteins. Chylomicron is the bigger in the size and the HDL is the smaller in size. Now we will see composition and characteristic of lipoproteins. So as we have already discussed, chylomicron is the bigger in size and HDL is smaller in size. Chylomicrons are synthesized in the intestine. VADL is synthesized in the liver. LDL is synthesized from VADL and HDL is synthesized in liver as well as in the intestine. Chylomicrons has a least density while HDL has a highest density. Apoproteins which are present in the chylomicrons are ApoA, ApoB48, ApoC and ApoE, while apoprotein present in the VADL are ApoB100, ApoC and ApoE. Apoprotein which is present in the LDL is ApoB100 and the apoproteins present in the HDL are ApoA, ApoC, ApoD and ApoE. LDL contain only single apoprotein, that is ApoB100, while other lipoprotein contains multiple apoproteins. Now we will see the protein and lipid content of each lipoproteins. Allomicron contain least protein content, that is 2%, while HDL contain highest protein content, that is 50%. Allomicrons contain higher lipid content, that is 98%, while HDL contain lowest lipid content, that is 50%. Now we will see individual components. Chylomicrons have higher content of triacylglycerol, that is 90%. Lowest amount of triacylglycerol is present in the HDL, that is 5%. Highest amount of protein is present in the HDL, that is 50%, and the lowest amount of protein is present in the chylomicron, that is 2%. Highest amount of cholesterol is present in the LDL, that is 50%, and highest amount of phospholipid is present in the HDL, that is 30%. So this is the table showing the composition and characteristic of lipoproteins. Now we will see the functions of lipoproteins. The function of chylomicrons, which are formed in the intestine, is to carry dietary triacylglycerol, which is also known as exogenous triacylglycerol, to the liver. And the function of VLDL, which is formed in the liver, is to carry endogenous triacylglycerol. Chylomicron carries exogenous triacylglycerol and VLDL carries endogenous triacylglycerol. Function of intermediate density lipoprotein, which is formed from VLDL, is to form LDL, that is low density lipoprotein. And the function of low density lipoprotein is to deliver cholesterol and cholesterol ester to the extrahepatic tissues. And the function of HDL, which is known as a good cholesterol, which is formed in the liver as well as in the intestine, is to deliver cholesterol from peripheral tissues to the liver and other steroidogenic tissues. So this is the table showing the functions of various lipoproteins. Now we will see the functions of apolipoproteins. Protein component of lipoproteins are known as apolipoproteins. First, we will see the function of ApoA1. ApoA1 is the structural component of high density lipoprotein, and that's why it acts as a ligand for HDL receptor. Another important function of ApoA1 is it activates lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. Thus, it plays very crucial role in the reverse cholesterol transport. So, this is all about the function of ApoA1, which is the structural component of HDL. Now, we will see the function of ApoB100. ApoB100 is the structural component of LDL as well as VLDL, and it acts as a ligand for LDL receptor. Now we will see the function of ApoB48. ApoB48 is the structural component of chylomicrons. ApoC2 plays very important role in the activation of lipoprotein lipase, while ApoC3 will inhibit the lipoprotein lipase. ApoC2 will activate lipoprotein lipase and ApoC3 will inhibit the lipoprotein lipase. And the last is the ApoE. ApoE is the arginine-rich apoprotein, and it acts as a ligand for LDL receptor as well as for the chylomicron remnant receptor. And the ApoE gene exhibits polymorphism. That's why it results in the expression of three common isoforms, that is ApoE2, ApoE3, and ApoE4. Among all these three isoforms, ApoE3 is the most common, and the individuals which carry two ApoE4 alleles are most prone for the development of Alzheimer's disease, while individuals carrying two ApoE2 alleles are more prone to develop type 3 hyperlipoproteinemia. So that is about ApoE. ApoE4 individuals carrying are more prone to develop Alzheimer's disease, while ApoE2 allele, which is present in the individuals, are more prone to develop type 3 hyperlipoproteinemia. Now we will see various multiple choice questions. The first question, which was asked in NEET 2019, Alzheimer's disease is associated with which apolipoprotein, and the options are ApoE1, ApoE4, ApoE3 and ApoE2. As we have already discussed, ApoE3 is the most common one, and the individuals which are carrying two alleles of ApoE2 are more prone to develop type 3 hyperlipoproteinemia, and the individuals carrying two alleles of ApoE4 are more prone to develop Alzheimer's disease. So the correct answer is B. Second question, which was asked in PGI November 2018, apoprotein integrated with high density lipoprotein, and the options are ApoA1, ApoA2, ApoD, ApoB100 and ApoB48. So the correct answer is A, B and C. That is ApoA1, ApoA2 and ApoD. Third question, which was asked in AIIMS November 2016. HDL has highest content of saturated fatty acid, triacylglycerol, cholesterol and apolipoprotein. So we all know correct answer that the highest content which is present in HDL is of protein. So the correct answer is D, apolipoprotein. While the lowest content of protein is present in the chylomicron. Fourth question is, which is the ligand receptor present in the liver for the uptake of ADL, which was asked in May-November 2009, and the options are ApoE, ApoA and ApoE, ApoE and ApoB100 and the ApoB100. So the correct answer is ApoB100, that is B. Triacylglycerols are maximum in, it was asked in AIIMS May 2007, and the options are chylomicrons, VADL, LDL and HDL. So the highest amount of triacylglycerol is present in the chylomicrons, while the lowest amount of triacylglycerol is present in the HDL, and the highest amount of cholesterol is present in the LDL. So the correct answer is A, chylomicrons. Major transporter of cholesterol to peripheral tissue. It was asked in PGI 2011. The options are HDL, LDL, VLDL and chylomicron. The major transporter of cholesterol to the peripheral tissue is LDL. So the correct answer is B. Last question is, all of the following statements are true about apoproteins except. And the options are apoproteins A1 activates lecithin cholesterol acid transferase, apoprotein C1 activates lipoprotein lipase, apoprotein C2 inhibits the lipoprotein lipase, and D, apoprotein C2 activates lipoprotein lipase. So the correct answer is C, apoprotein C2 inhibits lipoprotein lipase. Apoprotein C2 activates the lipoprotein lipase. So the correct answer is C. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it.